Hello everybody. In this video, I will show how to design a three-dimensional space frame. I have considered a beam column layout like this. Here, the first span or the first bay is 5 meters in length. Second bay is 4 meters in length, and the third bay is 5 meters in length. And that is along the length of the beam. Along the width, which is in the z direction, I have 4 meters first bay, 3 meters, 3 meters second and third bay, and again 4 meters the fourth bay. I have taken rectangular columns and have been placed as I have shown in the figure. The intention of placing the columns in such a fashion is that if I take the first frame, usually when there is a continuity in the beam, when the beam is continuous over the columns, and the length of the each bay is same, if suppose, then there will not be any moment transferred to the column. Under gravity loads. Any moment will not be transferred, only the axial load from the beams will be transferred. So since the bending will not be there, the bending of the column will not be there, I have oriented this column in the vertical direction rather than putting that in the horizontal direction. In the vertical direction, what is happening here? The beam is continuous until this point, then after this column, the beam is not continuous. So then what will happen? At the ends, you will find a larger moment that is to be resisted by the column. This column will resist lesser moment. If all the spans are same, then this will also not exhibit any bending moment in this direction, which is the, as per this column, this is the minor axis direction. And again, since this is continuous, this column also exhibit lesser moment. This will also exhibit lesser moment. However, this is the end column. This will exhibit larger moment, which I'm going to also show when we solve the problem in the stat. So that is why the orientation is made vertical here. Similarly, this beam is also continuous in this direction, but at the end it is not continuous. Therefore, this column will exhibit large bending moment in this direction rather than this direction. Okay, it exhibits bending moment vertically rather than horizontally. However, why I have provided these columns in this direction orientation rather than the vertical is because you have the these are also continuous. I can keep these columns in the vertical direction itself, not a big issue. But however, why I have placed this is because here also the beam length is more. When you design for bending of these longer beams, you have to always design it at the column face. The bending moment obtained at the column face rather than bending moment obtained at the center. Usually, bending moment obtained at the center will be more than the bending moment obtained at the column face. Hence, the bending moment obtained between this column face and this column face are only considered for the design of this beam, rather than considering at the center. That is as per IS code. Okay. So in that way, I can reduce the length of this beam for obtaining the bending moment, for considering the bending moment. That is one criteria. The other criteria is, if there is difference in the length, as in this case, this is 5 meters, this is 4 meters, when this difference in length, then this in this direction, the column will exhibit more bending moment than this direction, because this direction the length is small. Okay, so that is one of the things. I'll show this load distribution diagram that will help you in understanding much better. This is the load distribution diagram. This is a rectangular panel of the slab. So the load from the slab, whatever the load you assign from the slab, it will be distributed as a trapezoidal load to this column, which is the larger area that will come onto the longer beam. So here also the trapezoidal area, which is the larger area in compared to these triangles, that will transfer the load onto this longer beam. Similarly, in the next adjacent slab also, this trapezoidal area will be transferred to this beam itself. So therefore, large beam is experienced by the longer beam than the shorter beam. You can see here the shorter beam is experiencing a smaller triangular load from this panel, and from this panel, a smaller triangular load from this panel. You can see that since this is 4 meter by 4 meter, this panel is a square panel, and hence the load distribution is triangle on all the four sides. However, here it is a rectangular panel. That is why on the shorter side you have a smaller distribution of the load, whereas in the longer side you have larger distribution of the load. Okay. So these columns, these in between beams will exhibit more load, and hence they will have more bending, due to which the column will also experience more bending in the asymmetrical length of the beams. And there is asymmetrical length of the beams. If there is symmetry, this is 5 meter and this is 5 meter, then this column will never experience any moment due to symmetry in nature. Only the end columns, because of the discontinuity, they will experience larger bending when compared to the internal columns. But since in this case there is a difference in the span, I have considered the orientation to be like this rather than this, because this is the longer. You have longer length of the beam, here also longer, here also it is longer. Large bending moment will be experienced by this column, and therefore it has to be much stiffer in this direction. Since these beams are lesser, also their load sharing is less, the bending moment exhibited in this direction will be less on the column than this direction. Therefore, since the bending moment exhibited is less, I have oriented the column like this. Suppose if the length of the beam in this direction is more than this direction, then I would have oriented this column vertically rather than horizontally. But depending on the load sharing, we have to orient the columns on the major axis. Where you get more bending moment, to that direction you have to place the major axis. You have to place the minor axis where you get the lesser load. Okay. Usually, in any practical case, you get the rectangular columns only. Only in case of the office buildings, you may get the square columns. So, and these are the beams you have seen. The beam I have considered is 230 by 450 mm, and the column is also 230 by 450 mm. Then the number of floors is G plus 5, height of each floor is 3 meter, thickness of the slab is 150 mm, main wall 230 mm, brick on periphery beams, and the parapet wall is 115 mm brick wall. So loadings, since the thickness of the slab we are assuming as 150 mm, therefore it is 0.15 into 25, This is equal to 3.75 kilonewton per meter square, where 25 is the unit weight of RCC. And apart from that, usually there will be a floor finish and ceiling plaster on the slab. So that we will take it as 1 kilonewton per meter square. Total dead load is 4.75 kilonewton per meter square. The main wall, the weight of the main wall or the load from the main wall is, how to calculate that? This is 230 is the thickness, which is 0.23 into height of each story. I have considered in this case as 3 meters. 3 meters. See, in that 3 meter, the entire thing will not be the wall. There will be beam also. So therefore, I am deducting 450 mm depth of the beam, because I have considered the beam as 230 by 450. The depth of the beam is 450 mm. Hence, I will deduct that. Then I will multiply by the unit weight of the wall, brick wall. So that will give you 11.73 kilonewton per meter. Then I will consider parapet wall, which is 0.115 meters, that is 115 mm, into the height of the parapet wall will normally range between 0.6 to 0.75 meters. I have considered 0.75 in this case, into 20 will be 1.725 kilonewton per meter. Okay. The live load on all the floors is 2 kilonewton per meter square, which is the residential load, live load on the residential building. But you have to consider on the terrace, it will be as 1.5 kilonewton per meter square, because normally there will not be much occupancy on the terrace when compared to the regular floors. This is the 1.5 kilonewton per meter square is also suggested by the Indian Standard Code for the terrace case. This is about the geometry of the building and the loadings. Now we will move on to the StatPro and see how to analyze and design this building using StatPro software. As usual, you can just open StatPro, go to new project. Here, since this is the space frame, I will consider space. The structure, I will give it as the name as G plus 5 building. And location, you can save in whichever the folder you want. I have taken VK8 software class STAD. In that folder, I am saving this. The length, units of the length should be in meters, and that of the force is in kilonewtons. Next, finish. Yeah, we will cancel this snap node option. What we can do is, we can go to geometry, go to run structure wizard. Go to run structure wizard. You will get something like this. So go to frame models here. Go to frame model. Take the bay frame. The length. What was the length in the horizontal direction? The first bay was 5 meters, second bay was 4 meters, third bay was 5 meters. It is 14 meters, right? The height, since we are considering the G plus 5 story building, so totally it is 6 floors. Each floor is 3 meters, hence it becomes 18 meters. In the width direction, you know that first bay is 4 meters, second and third was 3 meters, and the fourth was 4 meters, hence it is 6 plus 4 is 10, 10 plus 4 is 14 meters. This is also 14 meters. Now, number of bays along the length, we have considered 3 bays, which is 5 meter, 4 meter, and 5 meter. In the height, along the height, it is 6 bays, since it is J plus 5 building, totally 6 bays. And number of bays along the width, you know, it is 4 bays. Now, since the along the length, the each bay is not of same length, what we should do is we should click on this, and we have to reset this one as like the first bay is 5 meters, second was 4 meters, and this 4 meters, and third one is 5 meters again. Okay, then click on OK. And this you need not change because 18 divided by 6 is 3 meters. Each floor will be 3 meters only. They are equal, you need not change. And along this width direction, width direction is this, that direction, you have to change. Click on here. It shows equally, but we have to change. The first bay was 4 meters, second was 3 meters, third was 3 meters, and the fourth is 4 meters. Okay. Click on OK. Go to apply. This is the model which is created. Just go and do cancel. Cancel. It is asking us to transfer, whether to transfer this prototype into STATFOR US. Let X and Y, XYZ coordinate be 0. Okay. Come to know. What is the length of that? This is 5 meters. This is 4 meters and this is 5 meters as we have considered. This is 4 meter length, 3 meters and 4 meters. Okay. Close. Now I'll go to the front view. I'll go to general, go to support. See, in buildings, all supports will be fixed supports, create, fixed, add, okay, they highlight this support, click on that support too, you just click on and drag or select the nodes using the node cursor, you should use node cursor and select the nodes. In the 3D structure, what will happen, if you select these nodes, automatically the other nodes will also get selected. Suppose if you keep 3D like this and select these nodes, you will have to select each one by pressing the control button. Okay, by pressing the control button. However, that can be easily done by going to the front view and drag and select the all the nodes, so that automatically the other nodes will also get selected and assigned to the selected nodes. So all the columns were assigned with the supports. Okay. Next, we will go to property. Now, first we will define all the columns. Then I will define the beam. So what was the size of the columns we have taken? It is 230 by 450, but there are two kinds of orientations. First one is horizontal 450 and the vertical is 230. The other type is horizontal 230 and vertical is 450. There are two types, is it not? So I will take first one as 450 by 230. See, for 450 by 230, what you should do, always you should bear in mind that for columns, YD is the horizontal width. YD is the horizontal length or width. ZD is the vertical length or width. Okay. Since I am considering 450 by 230, the horizontal will be 450 and vertical will be 230. Hence, it is 0.45 by 0.23. Add for vertical column, width is 0.23 and the length is 0.45. Add. Okay. And for beams, you should take yd as the depth and zd as the width for beams, that is regular. 0.45 is the depth, yd, and zd is 0.23 for beams. And now I will close this. Okay. Now to assign this to the respective columns, what I will do, I will go to select beams parallel to Y, new view, okay. I will go to the plan by clicking on this button. I will go to the plan. Now I have the plan here. Now first one, I will take 0.45 by 0.23. 0.45 by 0.23 means to say horizontal is 0.45 and the vertical is 0.23. And you know that from the diagram which we saw earlier, our columns, we have oriented this column in the horizontal direction. First column is 450 by 230, end is 450 by 230. All these interior columns are 450 by 230, and the corner columns are 450 by 230. Only these four columns are the 230 by 450. 230 by 450. Let me go back to STAT. So what I will do, this 450 by 230, there are so many numbers. So what I will do, first I will select and assign the columns, the size of the columns which possess less number of columns, which possess only four columns are 230 by 450. Therefore, first I will select them and I will assign. Okay, remaining are there. Instead of selecting each and every one, what you can do, you can go to select by missing attributes. By missing attributes, which is missing property. Attribute is missing property. If you click that, you can see in this view, whatever the column which is not assigned with the property gets automatically highlighted. And therefore, you can select this. First, you have to click on this. Then you will have to go to select by missing attributes, missing property. If you click on like that, you can directly assign them. You need not select each and every one. If you don't use this command, then you'll have to select this, hold control button, select these things, or drag and select, like this you can make. Or the easiest way would be first assign to the members which have the the size of the beam for which you have a lesser number of members. The larger number of members, you can just go to select by missing attributes and missing property. Means they get automatically highlighted, missing properties, and you can just assign to that. Okay, go to whole structure. Now we will have to assign to the beams. For that, what you should do, select beams parallel to X direction, select beams parallel to Z direction. Again, for that, before I should highlight here, otherwise it will not assign. Select beams parallel to X, select beams parallel to Z. Now you assign. Assign to the selected members. Okay. Now I have assigned the properties to all the members. I move on to loading. Loading. The loading, load case details, and I get that. Add. You know the loads. The first one is the dead load. I will first give the title as DL, capital D. Will be capital DL is the dead load. And the next one is live. I will use LL, live load. And you know that we should use the combination 1.5 times. Dead load plus live load. I will just type here name as 1.5 times dead load plus live load. Dead load plus live load. Since both the primary loads have to be multiplied with 1.5, here I should do the default value AI, because the general format is AI into LI. LI is the load, AI is the load factor. So dead load 1.5, I can click like this, and live load 1.5, I can select and click like this. This is one way, or I'll bring both to the left hand side again. Since the load factor is same for both the load cases, I can select like this, or as it is, I can use this double arrow. Both the loads will automatically take a load factor of 1.5 as the load factor. Okay. For dead load, it is 1.5, and for live load, suppose it is 1.2, then I'll have to take separately. However, in this case, both are 1.5. I'm considering only gravity loads. So both I can take like this and close. Now, what are the dead loads? Add. See, I will first deal with the wall load, and then I will take the floor load. Wall load, first of all, I should use the self-weight command add, because I have to consider the self-weight of beams and columns also. Okay. Next is member load. You know that the wall load is a UDL, which is minus 11.75. We have used minus 11.73, minus 11.73, add, and that of the parapet wall is 1.725, and click again here, 1.725, add. Okay, I close this. So this, first, I will take the self-weight command, and I want to assign it to each and every member here. Therefore, I will take assign to view command, assign to all. So all are got highlighted. Means to say, the self-weight command has been assigned to each and every member. Okay. Next, I will go to front view. I will take the beams are the columns up to this floor, because the terrace I will have to assign the parapet load. So I will consider only beams from here to here. I will right click, go to new view. Okay, only those will get highlighted. Now I'll go to plan. This is the plan, and in that plan, what I will do, I will just select each and every beams like this. See, there are two ways. This is one way. When you also select the beams, this is how you have to do. You have to drag each and everything into. Or in this itself, if you can go to select beams parallel to x-axis and select beams parallel to z-axis, then there is no question of the column gets highlighted. Only we can see, right click, go to new view, only we can see the beams alone. I will now go to plan view. I will drag the required beams, because only the peripheral beams, we are taking the main walls. Only there I am assigning the loads. Therefore, I will just drag and select this member. Then I will hold up the control button and then drag this and select the other beam. Again, hold the control button, drag this, drag this. So when you look at the isometric view, all the edge beams or the end beams have been selected for which we have to I should have selected this first. Anyhow, this has got highlighted. This for that beam, I will assign to the selected beams assigned. So now I have assigned 11.75 kN per meter as the main wall loading on the peripheral beams. Okay. Now I go to hole structure. Then I will move on to the terrace. I will select only terrace beams by dragging new view. Click new view. Okay. Go to plan. Now here I will select this first. Then I will select the first beam, second beam by holding control button. Fourth beam assigned to the selected beams. So now the peripheral columns of the terrace have been assigned a load of 1.725. Okay, I will go back to the whole structure. Now I will take the floor load, which is 4.75, which is the pressure actually. That is the pressure add, which includes the dead weights of slab and dead weight of floor finish and ceiling plaster. Put together, it was 4.75. For that, I will use floor load, which accommodates the pressure. That is why you have to use this load. So pressure minus 4.75. Where to where I should accommodate? See here, in this figure, from here the beam starts at 3 meters and ends at 18 meters. But if you want the same load for the entire beams, then you need not define X and Z range. X and Z range, only you should define Y range. What it will do, even if I take minimum as zero, nothing is going to happen, because at the zero level, we don't have any beams. We have beams only at the 3 meter level. Even if I give zero, it won't take. Okay, minimum zero. Maximum is maximum up to here, up to 18 meters, you have beams. I can take 20. Above 18, there is nothing. Therefore, even if I give 20, nothing is going to happen. Even if I give only 18, up to here, the loading will be taken. I will take 18, even if I can give 19, 20, anything you want. Okay. And then I will add. Now this has defined the slab weight and the floor finish and ceiling plaster weight. I'll close that and I'll just click on this. You will find the loads that have been assigned to each slab. Okay, this is what we were discussing, the load sharing. The load sharing, you know, this is 4 meter by 4 meter. This is the triangular load distribution onto the beam. This is the rectangular beam. There is a trapezoidal on the load distribution on the load share on the longer beam as well as this beam. And for the shorter beam, you have only the triangular load distribution. Okay. Similarly, others also you can observe. Okay. Next, we will move on to the live load. Live load is again the pressure 2 kN/m. Up to the 15 meter level, which is one floor lesser than the terrace floor, is it not? This floor load minus two is the pressure. Up to what I should do, I will take the isometric view, and you can see here this side, from 3 meters up to this floor level, I will assign 2 kN/m. Square as the the pressure, and at the terrace level, I should take 1.5 kN/m². Therefore, while describing the Y range, I will have to consider only up to 15 meters, not up to 18 meters for 2 kN/m². So it is 0 to 15. I will just add And one more is what? The last one, which is at the terrace, I am going to provide a live load of 1.5 kN per meter square, which starts from, if I give 15, what is going to happen? Even 15 will also take the 1.5 kN per meter square load. Therefore, instead of 15, I will use 16. And maximum is 18 or 19 or 20 or whatever. So I will add and close this. Now you can see the 2 kN per meter square is assigned only up to the fifth floor. And on the terrace floor, only 1.5 kN per meter square is being assigned. Okay, this is the load assignment. There are no any other loads to be assigned. We have completed all these things. And we have completed the property, we have assigned the support, we have taken the load definition. Now we will move on to the, either you can directly go to analysis, or if you want to design using StatPro, then you will have to go to design. Here you have design command, just click on that. Go here, you can go to concrete. The first one is steel, don't use that because ours is RCC structure. Concrete, concrete I will do. Then I will take the respective code. We have to use IS456. Now I will select parameters to be assigned to the columns and beams. Select. Here, usually everything will be selected, but I will bring them to the left hand side. We don't want everything. I will choose a few things like FC is the compressive strength of concrete. FY is the yield strength of the reinforcement. You can use maximum size of the bar, whatever you want, that you can use. Minimum size of the secondary reinforcement also you can use. Okay. In combination, what is the size of the main bars and what is the size of the the maximum size and minimum size, you can use that also. You can use that, and you have to use minimum main size bar size, minimum bar size for both main bars and secondary bars. You can use that, and you can take here FY secondary also. FY secondary. Apart from that, the main thing you have to use the ratio. Ratio you can use. Then at the end, you have to use track. Track add. If you don't use track, then you won't get the results that are to be highlighted. Okay, this is okay. Go to define parameters. See, FC is the grade of the concrete. I will consider M25 grade. So here I will, it has to be in kilonewton per meter square. It is 25 followed by three zeros. Will be in kilonewton per meter square. 25 newton per mm square is 25,000 kilonewton per meter square. And you add, then FY mean, ours is, I will use Fe500 steel. Therefore, I will take 500 followed by three zeros. And secondary, if you take the ductile detailing for considering the earthquake loads, then you'll have to use Fe415. But however, ours is not that case. Therefore, I will use 500 there also. 500 followed by 1, 2, 3 zeros. And maximum size of the main bar, I will consider 25 mm, because in buildings we don't go beyond 25 mm. And maximum secondary also I will use the 20 mm secondary. Add, then in combination, bars in combination, this is the main bar minimum size. Minimum size I will use 16 mm. Add MD2 is the main bar maximum size. that also will be 25, and minimum secondary reinforcement I will take, I mean main reinforcement minimum I will take 16 mm minimum. And although 12 mm is also actually as per code 12 mm is the minimum, but I'll take 16 mm here. Minimum secondary also I will take that you can keep it as 8 mm itself, because secondary maybe for columns it will be ties. So for tie you cannot use 16 mm and all, you will have to use 8 mm only, 6 mm is not available. And ratio, it is the maximum percentage of reinforcement that is allowed in beams and columns as per IS 456 is 4% only. However, in columns you can go up to 6%. If you go for 6%, then you cannot give lapping. Therefore, I will use 4% only. And then track is will give the selected designs. I will use 1 instead of 0. This will give intermediate level of detailing. Okay, for the details and close. So I have taken all these things here defined. I will now assign these to the beams and columns. See, FC25, I want it for both columns and beams. Therefore, I will use assign to view. Assign to view command, I have assigned. And FI secondary also. Sorry, FI main. I will give assign to view, because for beams and columns, both we are using 500 FE 500 grid only. Secondary also FE 500 grid for both. Maximum main bar for both is 25. This is also for both. 16 for both. Assigned to you since everything we are providing for both the members. Main 16. Assigned to you. Assigned to you. Then this for both beams and columns, 4% is the maximum. Track assign to view. Okay. Now these are the parameters we have assigned. Now we have to tell the STAT software to design beams and design the columns. So for that we should go to commands, design beam, add, design column, add. Close. Okay. Now, since I have to assign it for separately for beams and columns, I will go for select command, select beams parallel to x-axis, select beams parallel to z-axis, see. X and Z. And assign it. Okay. Now design beam has been assigned to the beams. Now you'll have to assign the column design for columns. Select beams parallel to Y. This will assign the columns to design. Okay. Now we have completed all the formalities for design. We will go to commands, analysis, perform analysis. Okay, analyze, run analysis, save, no print option. Now you can see that there are zero errors and zero warnings. Done. Now everything is finished. Now you have to view the beam designs. For that, what you can do, if you want to view for each floor, you can take the first floor or the ground floor like this. Go to right click, new view, okay. Go to 3D or isometric view. You can just double click on each beam and see what is the reinforcement required. Here it is, top bar 3 of 16. Okay, here it is 3 of 16 top bar, at this support also 3 of 16, whereas in the midpoint mid span you require only 2 of 16. See how in the cross section how it looks, the top bars are 3, so obviously there should be 2 bars to be given at the bottom. If there is 3 bars here, you can just curtail the mid bar, you need not take that up to the support. And in the mid span, you have 3 bars here, 3 bars here. Actually, you can curtail. You will see the detailing in some later on in some other video. I will come up with that. And this is 3 bars at the top and 2 bars at the bottom. And this is also 3 bars at top and 2 bars at the bottom. This is how you can just note down in a sheet of paper, write down the beams, note down what is the reinforcement required, and that you can just plot it in the AutoCAD in the later stage. So this is the second beam. This is top 216, bottom 216, top 216. See what you saw earlier in this beam, it was 316 here at the top. Here it is 216. So actually, while doing the drawing, you'll have to consider 316 for both the beams up to 0.3L, up to 0.3L this side and 0.3L that side. Okay, you cannot take the lesser value. So here you have 2 of 16. When I click on this, you get 3 of 16. Again, here also you should take top reinforcement as 3 of 16 only, not 2 of 16. Okay. Again, you can come to this. You can see what is the reinforcement required. What is the reinforcement required? What is the reinforcement required? Like this, you can just note down and produce the drawing in the AutoCAD or any other related softwares. Okay. And also you can see here, this indicates that you need 17 bars, 17 rings, which are the stirrups, which is 8 mm dia at 145 mm center to center. 145 mm center to center is the shear reinforcement required. Okay, that is also the. If you want the column reinforcements, you can just double click on the columns. Columns, you take concrete design. Okay, here you can see. It says 16 bars of, 16 dia, 8 numbers are required. 8 numbers are required. 16 mm bars, 8 numbers are required. Click on this. Similarly, 16 dia of 8 bars. This, if you click 16, 8 bars of 16 again. Okay. Just because I have given minimum reinforcement to be 16 itself, it is taking 16 mm bar size, 16 mm bar size. Like this, what you can do, you can select the beams parallel to Y, go to new view, right click new view, you can select the columns, and if you click on this column, you can just note down what is the reinforcement required. Here it is 8 of 16. Here also it is 8 of 16, 8 of 16, 8 of 16, 8 of 16, and 8 of 16. For this column, you need from the bottom to the top 8 of 16 bars. If you want to take any middle column, what you can do, go to plan, and just select that column, right click, new view, okay. Okay, middle columns. You can just double click on this 8 of 16, 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 and 8 of 16. Here also you require 8 of 16 throughout. Okay, this is what the design says. Probably if I would have given 12 mm as the minimum size, the area AST, which we are providing 1.55%, would have reduced, because AS required is only 120 here at the top, whereas at the bottom, AS required is 899 mm square, area of steel required, 899 mm square. Since I am providing 16 mm bars and 8 bars, the AST is 1.55%. This is the 201, 16 mm dia is 201 is the area into 8. This is giving 1600 mm square. We are providing 1600 mm square reinforcement, although we require 899 only. You can just reduce the bar size as 12 mm. I can do that here. See, I have taken the minimum bar size as 16. Instead of that, if you just double click, this will automatically get highlighted. So go to 12, modify this, close. Okay. And you can see, I think I'll have to analyze again. See, since we have made changes. Now, if you see this, you require only 8 bars of 12 dia, which will give a AST percentage of 0.87. You know that for the column, 0.8% is the minimum, 0.87 it is coming, then it is no problem. Suppose if this is 0.7, we should be very much cautious, because 0.8 minimum we should give. Okay. This is what is happening everywhere. 8 bars of 12 dia is only sufficient. That you should note. Okay. This is how we have to analyze and design while doing any design of residential building or apartment buildings or any other type of buildings. You can just keep on noting down, right in a format of paper or in Excel sheet, the reinforcements required. Then you can make combinations, and then you can submit it to the client through the AutoCAD drawings. This is all I wanted to give the information in this video. Thank you.